All right, folks, welcome back. Sorry I've been away for a little bit. I had to tend to some family matters, but Dr. Kranke's back. Last time you saw this, it was basically drying, and it's had plenty of time to dry. Now, some of the things that you see here are little details that I've added. Remember, we started with the two cinder blocks, but then I added some metal, real metal that I've rusted just to have strewn around. I added a little rock here, a piece of wood, corrugated tin, which you could do with a paint tube squeezer that you get at an art supply store. And nothing. It's dried nicely. This is a twig from the garden, which has a lot of character because it's got some of the bark coming off. So I put that at the front. Now, one of the things that you need to do when you're working on a base like this is you constantly need to keep having to come back and test the fit of your model, how your model's going to look. I mean, that's part of the fun. And so you want to engage in it. Right now, remember, it's just everything is glued down. Nothing's going to move, so you have nothing to worry about in terms of breaking stuff. Here's the model that's still in progress, and see, it fits right into the little grooves, the little indentations that had been made so that it fits right on there. I don't know exactly how this thing is going to be displayed, whether the front's going to be the you know, when I display it, let's say at a show or in the display case, I don't know exactly how I'm going to display it, but I know that, you know, the bullseye, it's namesake, so I've got to fix that up. I don't know if you could see it, but anyway, you see the model in place. Eventually, I'm going to glue it down because the rear tires need to look sunk in. The brake drums are sunk in also in the front. And so you see that the space that you have around the model is just dedicated turf with some details showing here and there. So it's going to be very easy to do. That's why I'm telling you, don't be afraid to make your model stand out by building a sweet little base for it. Okay, and that way it keeps the eye. It keeps the viewer's eye on the model and on the base. There's going to be probably some turf. Don't worry about the darkened spots here. Everything's got that grainy sand look. And eventually I'll come back in probably with the airbrush and paint it our earth color. So everything's going to blend in real nice. And so that's it. So you take the next step I'm going to show you here. You remove your model, being careful, you know. Now, as I said, everything is dry. I made my little mixture of white glue, about 75% white glue, and then a couple of drops of liquid soap, all right, and then water. The rest is water. You can use distilled water, but tap water is the same thing. I've got my handy water mister, which I want to use because you want everything to stick once you start layering in. So you moisten everything. It doesn't matter. Everything will dry up nicely again. All right. This is a container that had, I think, some sort of perfume in it. So all these months, all these years, the perfume, I could still smell the perfume. It's great. So anyway, now the fun begins. I had shown you that I had different colored dirt and little pieces of moss and, you know, ground up stuff. And so you just come back in and start adding little details, you know, more color, more texture, which is still dirt, but you want to add a little bit of a variety here, not too much, just a little bit to make things stand out. And it's going to stick right now because the surface is moist, which is fine. So I hope you can see this. Different color dirt, different just different varieties of dirt that you can pick up in your, and different size grains too, you know, from fine to a little thick, and you can add little bunches of it here and there. Remember, it's going to be, you know, most of this is going to be touched up with the airbrush anyway, because you want a little bit more uniformity, but you want some of the real colored dirt to show through. All right, and this is your chance to to go crazy on this stuff if you want. It's not going to hurt anything. See? So you just put it on there. I've got my little plastic cover underneath so that I don't make a mess. You could turn it around and make sure that you're getting a little bit of everything, of all that dirt, different colored dirt here and there. All right. Again, the edges, I'm not too worried about, because the edges, actually, that's exactly what I want it to do. I don't want that much grain on there, but because I'm going to hit it up with the airbrush and then sort of layer everything from the edges of the base upward. And once we get the grass and all the other stuff, you're not going to be able to tell. All right. So you begin to see how I'm layering this stuff in there. And again, I have a whole bunch of different collection of colored dirts. I happen to be in North Florida, which is close to southern Georgia, which has the finest red dirt I've ever seen. So every chance I get, I ride my motorcycle out there with a plastic baggie. I collect different kinds of, people think I'm crazy, but that's all right. I know I'm crazy. So there you see it. Okay, some of this corroded metal are just bits and pieces that I made a long time ago, and so I have a healthy supply of it exactly for these moments. Okay, so that's pretty much it. You just want a little bit of variety. Don't be afraid to get it on the on the surface of the wood here or the metal. It's okay. So now I've got a layer that I'm pretty happy with, right? So you come back, and again, this is kind of, some people might think this is tedious. I enjoy it, but you got to go drop at a time, okay, and make sure and let each drop spread, because that's going to give you an idea of coverage, and that's exactly what's going to make the layering stick to the original base that you've got going on here. And it'll dry, once again, it'll dry flat, and it'll dry, you won't even know that there's any glue there, which is why you just thin the glue down, and then you moisten it so that the glue can spread without, and it absorbs into the base without any problems. See? So right there, it's just, and you don't have to go crazy with it. I mean, you don't have to cover the whole thing again with glue. You just want to hit up the spots where you want some of that new dirt to stick to. Okay, here we go. Well, we got an interesting area here. I've got this log that's sunken in a little bit at the edge of the front of the Impala where the model's going to be. So I've added plenty of glue there, and there are a couple of seams right in here. And so I'm going to come back in with my dirt and just add a little bit more on there, which is perfect. And this is part of the original dirt or sand, and that's it. You just, again, go through it, and now once you've added a top layer on top of the glue and you think it's going to have a hard time sticking, shake it up again, and once again, drop enough on there so that it absorbs, and you're going to see the transformation that this base will take once I basically get to the next stage, which is just adding a little bit more of this dirt, and then I'll break out the airbrush and begin to unify the colors of the dirt. And then the next stage after that, I think I'll just photograph, because I want the photographs to show you exactly in detail. The camera, this camera is good, but it doesn't focus as much as I would like it to. So next stage, I'm going to show you probably the base, the finished base, before things like clumps of weeds and maybe a little bit more trash and the model in there. So the next stage for this will be probably a little video slide of the photographs I will take. But there it is. You see it? It darkens up once again. Once you apply the glue, it darkens up here and there. So because it, of course, the glue is wet. So there it is, and stay tuned for more. I hope you enjoyed this little mini series, and that now you're not afraid to set your model off on a nice base I redid the tape. I'm sure you noticed it before it was blue. Now it's just plain beige tape because, I'm a neat freak and I like to keep it clean, keep the edges clean because that's the part of the base that that's going to be nice to look at. Probably will be shiny. Anyway, stay tuned in for the next stage, which is probably near completion, and you'll see what it looks like shortly. So, thank you.